Welcome back to Let's Play Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're gonna stop some monsters. Ah! A meeting with monsters. Litten says, damn, we are no match for them. Yeah, they're way too gloopy for you. And have too few eyes. Or says, we sure got ourselves in trouble while Baron is away. So I don't know why they call him the Baron. Mile says, is everyone alright? Avin says, we're adventurers from the guild. Leave these monsters to us. Thank the gods. We have help, says a worker. Or says, please take care of them. And take care of them we shall. I'm gonna use a finishing move, Sonic Sword, on this guy. Avin will just attack. I mean, Mile will just attack. Duh. Increased speed. How dare you. Wait, this one's damaged, right? Get this one. And then there was one. Who missed? What a sad state of affairs for you, Rapu BB. Sounds like the name of a rap artist. A sad name, but a name nonetheless. Rapu BB lays down the good beats. Oh, they're all squished. Look at that. All that's left is a squished eye and, like, some gunk. Avin says, we've killed most of them. That you killed all of them. Litten says, you're really strong. You deserve the reputation of the guild. Thank you for saving us, says Oris. A man's voice says, what happened? Alright, mystery man coming up. Oh, there's those! Litten says, Baron! Oris says, Baron, welcome home. Oh, so the well-dressed man? Hi, everyone. I'm sorry I was away when this happened. So who killed all these monsters? These two did, says Oris. Oh, you! We met you on the bridge a short while ago, says Mile. My name is Conrad. I'm the Lord of Baloa. He was doing a special voice for him, and I had no idea that he was anyone important. Thank you for killing the monsters. On behalf of the people of Baloa, I express my sincere gratitude. You too. Thank you for your effort. I don't think the monsters will come back anytime soon, so please go back to town. Okay, says Litten. We can leave now that the Baron is back. Now you're calling him the Baron, like you should. Thank you. See you later, Baron, says Oris. As he just said... Well, it wouldn't make sense to say, see you later, the Baron. That's true. So you're a Baron, says Avin. I'm Avin. I'm Mile. A young sailor says, Avin and Mile. Are you the adventurers who killed the monsters in Guia? The plant manager in Guia told me the story. Well, it wasn't much, says Avin. Mile asks, do you know the plant manager? I'm Thomas. I'm working on a boat called the Planetos. Cool name. I often visit the plant in Guia to order parts for the Planetos. Right, says Avin. Perhaps we should sit down and talk. Avin, Mile, why don't you come to my house? Let me offer you a meal as a token of my appreciation. I like that voice. Thank you, but we have something to do, says Avin. We are looking for someone in Baloa. Looking for someone? Then maybe I can help. Our family manages the port. We keep the list of passengers on the ferries. That's great. Mile says, then perhaps we should take the Baron's offer. All right, then. Thomas, are you joining us? I'd love to, but I can't. I must check the cargo before the Planetos arrives. Oh, that's too bad. Well, I must get going. Avin and Mile, I may be able to help you too. After I finish checking the cargo, I'll be at the Sailor's Tavern. Come see me there if you like. Bye! Okay, we should head back to town too. My house is right after the entrance to the port. Yeah, we know where it is. Oh, Conrad joined the party? Really? Okay. Look at these gloppy pieces. Too funny. Alright, Conrad, we got a baron. Sorry, guys. A baron in our party. He's got this Celtis, the Tonki, and Ringmail. I guess we'll give him some stuff. What's good? What's good for him? Magic Defense 52. This one's better. Starving. Magic Attack. Avoidance way up. Attack. Alright, let's take the Attack Power Wrist. Pretty dramatic with the avoidance. Let's get that up. Okay. Conrad knows spirit magic. He only has spirit Arachne. Spell with the power of the earth spirit. Pierces all enemies with sharp roots. That sounds interesting. And he's got a Hercules. It's a deadly, aka finishing move. Attacks the enemy with your own power and the power of the Earth Spirit. As far as a skill, we have Wood Chop. This single blow is enough to knock down a large tree. And Brandish swings an axe around to damage enemies. Interesting. Alright. Alright. Oh. Go around and talk to everybody again before we go to the Baron's house. Baron, you are home. I'm very sorry. Even though you entrusted me while you were gone. No, it's my fault this time. I shouldn't have left the town without thinking. I should have thought more about a good strategy for this kind of situation. We can't use an ordinary method to prevent the monsters. We'll have to discuss this matter soon. I understand. We will come up with a specific proposal about the guard of Beloa. I'll count on you. I said I'll count on you. Baron, I can't even let you do it. Please come to the front of the counter. That's funny. We don't need any of that stuff. Let's just check the weapon shop. Can't get behind that counter. Do we have a better axe? I think we do. Celtis is a halberd. Defense goes down because they think it's double. Two-handed. Attack goes way up though. Defense. Oh, what is he? I think he does have one of those shields. Mm. Here's the Tonki. I'm gonna keep him with what he has. Wah, wah. Guess who's here? Hello, Baron! Hello! What a warm and hearty greeting! Yes! Listen, Baron, I was playing hide and seek with my brother the other day. There were so many places to hide there, so it was a lot of fun. Let's play it together next time. Sounds like a lot of fun. Please let me join you when I have time. All right, promise me. Baron, don't forget our promise to play hide and seek together. Forget what? Ah, that's Baron. Hello! Hello! That's a hearty greeting. Yes. Baron, will you teach me how to handle an axe sometime? Handling an axe requires a special skill, so if you want to learn something, a sword is better, I think. Either way, I will teach you when you get bigger. Sounds like a plan. Oh, Baron, what happened to the monsters? They are all defeated. Are your family members all right? I can't believe those kids. I told them so many times not to go outside, but I guess they tried to. But because of it, we could find out about the monsters before they came inside the town. Ha! It's a meritorious deed. I envy you to have two active boys. That's one hell of a word, meritorious. Then why don't you have a child yourself, Baron? If you raise your children after you get old, you won't be able to keep up with them. Hmm. We've been down here. Just making sure I don't miss anything. Don't need your stinking rare potion. Don't need that either. Oh, hi, Baron. Are you on patrol? Thank you for your hard work. I deserve an answer. Oh. Don't need that either. Ugh. How do I get past these people again? Ugh. Is there anything going on? I heard children screaming. Yeah, we're just torturing them. You know how it is. Oh, Baron, thank you for your hard work. Jeez, we struggle past these people just to hear that. Ugh. They're being harassed by our cat. I heard it, Baron. You went to see the situation in Guia, right? How was Guia? I think there was an explosion at the factory, but the people are settled and a reconstruction has been going on. It's consoling to think that the damage by the monsters was limited. I see. That's a relief. I have friends in Guia. I'll go visit them when I have a time. When I have a time. How are you, Baron? How's Lady Teresa doing? Good, thanks. I had too much fun with that voice. Baron, don't you worry. We miners are really strong from digging holes. If the monsters show up when I'm around, I'll back you up. I'm gonna talk to him from here. Hello, Baron. I heard that the monsters attacked. Avin and his friends cleaned up. Such young people did? Avin and Mile are magnificent braves. I'm going to be hospitable to them at my mansion. Braves? Then please take this. The bartender handed Conrad a packet. It's our house specialty sardine. I don't know if it's to your taste. I appreciate the thought. Or your thought. How much would that be? Oh no, I'll be punished by heaven if I receive money. What? Having protected Beloa means the same as protecting my store. Please eat with relish. Thank you. I would not put relish on sardines if I were you. Please send best regards to Lady Teresa, too. Magnificent braves? Is that what he said? Well, let's bother this guy. So, you are Baron Conrad. I am the Merchant Garcia. I wish the tax of Beloa would be a little cheaper, or more ships would come in. Roses are necessary to run the port. If we lower the tax, we won't be able to even manage storages. Then that will affect you too. You got me. I'm no match for you, Baron. You're in a different class from the ordinary aristocrats or the priests. Even though you compliment me, I won't give you anything. That's funny. Okay. Did I talk to him? Oh yeah, I did. I talked to both of those. Okay. That might be it for this part of town. I talked to them. Yeah, it's like a longish section, but not wide. He's a mother and her two kids. Yeah, that's it. Alright. This guy in the storage. Oh, hello, Baron. The stuff in storage is according to the book as usual. It's good to hear. Thanks for your hard work. Oh, I'm not going there yet. I'm gonna check around first. Oh, this guy is singing a poet to the guy's wife. Here you come, Baron Conrad. You, the plunderer of beauty. Even though you are married with the Supreme Virgin, you have a girl in gold and red around. What a shame. I, the martyr of beauty poet Rowan, won't forgive your prodigality, even if Bardas would overlook it. She's our house guest. What do you want me to do? It's easy. I want you to introduce me to her. You are cunning. Why can you have two such beautiful women by you? Am I cunning? This is funny. My house is just inside the block. If you go this way, you'll get to the harbor. I'm sorry, but come back, will you? I really want to invite you to my house. Alright. Well, let's go this way first and talk to these people over here. Alright. Alright, nothing that way. There are a few more people this way to talk to. Oh, there's more people here now. Hello, Baron. How are you? Thomas is right here. Who's Thomas? It's better not to have a game with Thomas. He totally cleaned me out. Ha ha. Thank you for your advice. I'm fully aware that he is very good at his game. Cleaned out? Avin says. What are they talking about? Hick! Look, that's Baron. Ha ha! Your hairstyle is weird. Is this Thomas? Oh, that's Sailor Thomas, yeah. Hey, Avin. Do you want to play a game with me sometime? A game? With a sword? No, no, not with a sword. What I meant was... Hey, Thomas. Don't teach anything bad to pure young people. Just so you know, I can't play the game with you. My wife has been telling me not to play. Too bad. Hmm? Avin's confused. Women are so uptight. Playing a game excites a man's spirit, though. By the way, are you done checking all the cargo? We don't need no stinking cargo. Never did find out where exactly this waiting room is. I'm guessing it's this? There was something boisterous. What's going on in town? You don't deserve to know, right? Don't need that. The rumor says that the monsters may appear on the way to Valkt. I'm thinking about talking to the Adventurer Guild. I will pray for my grandpa to stay healthy when I go to the Holy Capital. Do you think Bardas will listen to me? How the hell am I? Should I know, lady? Alright, I think that's it. I'll just talk to them. I got stuck on that. Hold on a second. I got an itch on my back. Alright, let's go to the manor? I don't know what it is. Where the guy lives. The barony or whatever. Baron, welcome home. I heard that the monsters appeared at the entrance of the town. These two did a good job of driving the monsters away. I appreciate you two for standing watch. It was a great help since there were only women inside the house. No problem. We were just returning the gratitude that you've shown us. Then, please excuse me. You seem very well liked here, says Mile. That's a blessing. I'm only one man, but the people in town have helped so much. This is my house. Please make yourself at home. Woman yells, honey, are you home? Yeah, I just came back. This is my wife, Teresa. This is Avin and Mile. They got rid of the monsters at the entrance of the town. Thank you for your hard work. I'm Teresa, Conrad's wife. Nice to meet you. Avin says, nice to meet you too. Hello, says Mile. I'll go make some tea. Looked as stunned by her ravishing beauty. We have another guest staying with us, but I don't think you will mind since it's a young lady. Young, says Avin. God. Lady, says Mile. She's a really good girl, so I think you guys will get along well. Her name is Emel. Literally, I'm as shocked as Avin. Avin! The voice of a girl. Oh, we were just talking about you. Huh? How do you know his name? Emel, says Avin. Avin! Aw, it's Emel! Yay! Avin, my dearest brother. Teresa says, honey. Emel, is that really you? Aw, is she gonna cry? Look, your eyes are, like, watery. Hehe, Avin. Did you forget my face? How could I? No, relax, Avin. Email. Oh, my email. Avin. I wanted to see you. I've been longing to see you again. 8 years after the fall of Cathedral, Avin and Emel were finally reunited. Wow. Here, I didn't think it would happen till like the end of the game, or almost. They hugged each other firmly, as if they were making sure of each other's existence. A sea breeze of Beloa was blowing through gently, as if it were blessing these two. Avin says, I want to introduce you to someone. Imel, this is my best friend, Mile. We've been traveling together from Ort Village. How do you do, Mile? Thank you for being such a good friend to my brother. Nice to meet you, says Mile. Now I know why Avin bragged about you so much. I had no idea you were such a cute girl. Well... Mile, don't flirt with my sister. I just gave her a compliment. Besides, it's your fault, Avin. You talked about her so much, it made me curious. Something like, my sister is the cutest in the world, or she's like an angel, and so on. Imel says, Avin, you're embarrassing me. Avin says, because... It's all true. What's wrong with saying that? Ha ha ha. It's truly a good day today. Teresa says, Imel, I'm so happy for you. Congratulations on being reunited with your brother. Thank you, Lady Teresa. Avin says, Baron, Lady Teresa, thank you for having taken care of Imel. Don't mention it. What are you two going to do now? I'll be happy to have all of you stay with us. Actually, Avin told him what had happened so far and explained that they were headed for the holy capital, Valkt. I'm guessing it's Valkt. I see. To the city where the Grand Cathedral of Bardis is located. Imel, will you come with us? Says Avin. Of course. I will go anywhere with you. I can't stop you, but I'll surely miss you guys. Is he leaving the party already? I mean, we didn't get to fight with him or anything. However, today's ferry boat is already gone. Please at least stay here for tonight. We entertain you as much as we can. Teresa says, why don't you guys go for a walk in Beloa till dinner is ready? You haven't seen each other for a while. I'm sure you've got a lot to talk about. Thank you, Lady Teresa, Imel says. Avin says, okay, we'll stay if you insist. Avin says, where should we go then? You know Beloa more than I do. Do you have any recommendations? Imel says, let's see. I can't believe it's her. The view at the port is nice, and the lighthouse is big and cool, but I like the resting spot in the center of town. I know where that is, I think. Yeah, it's surrounded by a waterway, which helps me to relax. Okay, we can go there. Mile says, I'll be hanging out at the inn. Mile, you guys go catch up. Go have a good time. Mile, please don't go away, Imel says. I know that you and my brother are best friends. That's why I want to get to know you, too. Imel, says Mile. She's such a good girl. She's too good to be your sister, Avin. You jerk, why'd you say that? Anyway, let's all go together. But you two, don't get too friendly. Avin, stop it, says Imel. Mile says, ha, I'll be real careful. Then let's go for a walk. Alright, so now we got Imel with us, wow. Oh, she's not actually with us, as in the party. That's interesting. Yeah, she's just, like, following us. Oh, okay. Well, I guess we walk around and talk to everybody again. Let's go visit this crazy poet guy. Oh. Can we talk to her? No, right? Watch, he gives it up and is, like, falling in love with Imel instead. Oh! You were the girl in gold and red I was even dreaming of. Oh, it was her. Okay. This must be a strange chance of fortune by Bardis. I'm wandering poet Roland. Beautiful girl, may I ask your name? Avin. He's not talking to him. I'm not asking yours. Please, tell me your name. I'm Mile. Nice to meet you. I'm not asking yours either. All right. You won, says Avin. She is Roland. I've heard that name before. Heh, that's my name. The air here is pretty bad. Do you want to go somewhere else? Emil says, but... Come on, says Maya. Let's go to the harbor. Please, only your name. Nope. Request denied. Go. Wait. I wanted to get the thing the cat brought. Oh, the poet, writer's gone. I guess that's the lighthouse. Doesn't look much like a lighthouse. Yo, welcome. But a refined lady like you shouldn't be in a place like this. Ugh. Underage people shouldn't be in here. Be patient and read this instead. Nice! You got Swordmaster 5. Nice! Thank you for that. What did you say? Hehe. Underage people should get out. Hehehe. Hi there, you are Thomas, right? Says Avin. ML says, hello. Look at the cute girl. She's extra. Avin says, what do you mean by extra? Anyway, I thought you were supposed to check the cargo. Same to you. What's up with your people's search? Miles says, yes, we are through with that. Right, Avin? Yeah. Avin told Thomas about what had happened at the Baron's house. Is that right? I'm happy for you. Thanks. You're making it very difficult to flirt with her. You don't have to. She keeps, like, having dots like she's about to say something. I think. Since my granddaughter is with me, I decided to hire an adventurer to guard us on our way to Theta. I didn't have a problem hiring an adventurer at the guild because there was someone who was going to cross the ocean anyway. I'm glad that we could travel to Vogue safely. Is that true monsters are about to enter the town at the entrance? I've heard that Paloa is a safe town. Are we going to be okay? That was so last episode, lady. You are fine, Avin says. We defeated them. Actually, it was this episode. Did you really? We're adventurers, though we may not look like it. Cool. Then, if I'm ever in danger, will you come rescue me? Eh? Yeah. Promise me. Emil, what's wrong? Says Avin. Huh? What? Nothing. Mile, why are you laughing? Haha, I'm not laughing, he says as he's finishing laughing. Yes, you are, says Avin. You know what the dots. Promise me, you sexy adventurer. Please come rescue me if I'm ever in danger. Sexy adventurer. Are you getting on a boat too? Can I get on first? Emil says, okay, I will let you be the first one on a boat. Alright. I get on the boat first. I can't wait for the boat. Okay. I think that's it for this section. We can see the whole sea from here, says Avin. Was this what she was talking about? I thought she meant in the center of town. I think she does. ML says, it's a little disappointing that there is no beach in Beloa, but just feeling the sea breeze like this makes me relax. Avin says, the Ornt village Mile and I grew up in is in the mountains, so it's been a while since I've seen the ocean. Mile says, this is even my first time to ride a big ship like a ferry boat. I'm starting to get excited. Avin says, our journey will end when we arrive at Valt, at the other side of the sea. The journey was somehow long and short. Ah, says ML. What is it, ML? Oh. Bird? Oh, is it a seagull? Mile says, no, it looked a little different. It was a pigeon. She says, it had something tied to its foot. It looked like a carrier pigeon. Wow, ML. You could see that well, says Mile. Hehe, I have good eyes. But it's rare to see a carrier pigeon, says Avin. Who released it? Ah, it's back, says Mile. Where? Says Avin. Oh! Mile went into the drink. Ah! Says Avin. Mile? Says ML. You're mean, Avin. Says Mile. Mile, are you alright? Says ML. Yeah, I got wet, but I didn't get hurt. Anyway, you're so careless, Avin. And mean. Haha, you were lucky that you could swim, says Avin. I didn't swim. I was about to drown. I didn't know that the sea is this salty. Avin says, see, you could have a very precious experience. Avin, says ML. Say sorry to Mile. Well, sorry. Good boy. Mile says, haha, you are putty in ML's hands, Avin. Tch, says Avin. Anyways, says Mile, my clothes will get dry while walking, so let's go somewhere else. Yeah, good idea, says Avin. Well, that was a random thing. Did we find out what was attached to the bird's foot? Well, we can go this way now. Where's the guide? She left. Okay. Not much to see here. So to get back, we go this way. Again. Oh my, it's a hard job to organize the cargo. Good luck, says ML. Thanks. Your encouragement gives me energy. Oh, what's he say? A little more work to do. Okay. Did I talk to them before I went out of here again? Did we look around? Oh, they left automatically. Let's just go talk to them. I'm not prepared for a meal yet. Please come back after going for a walk. You two are finally reunited. Please take time to talk. Oops. Can't go that way, okay. Well, I think we've been running long enough. We're gonna head for that little area that she wants to go to. With the seats and the water around. First we'll check up on everyone else. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.